Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Pain for Fun. So today we are going to be painting a llama for Valentine's Day. So what we are going to be using is a few brushes. So I have my big flat brush here. It's about 3/4 of an inch. I have a medium flat brush, which is about 1/4 of an inch. And I also have a small round pointed brush. For the paint, I'm using acrylic and I'm using my primary colors, red, yellow, blue, black, and white. I have a canvas here that I already prepped. I'm gonna paint it black. I already did this, I let it dry. So you could do that beforehand. And once you are done, we are gonna get started. So I'm gonna start with a bit of white, just drawing out the outline of the llama. So I'm doing a diagonal line to start off and rounding it out at the top, right before the top of the canvas. So round it out and then you can go right back down again, kind of like a finger shape. So get your outline correct. Try not to go too big. You could adjust your shape later on. Start small and then we're gonna draw out the ears. So the ears, if they go a little bit off the canvas, that's fine. They're gonna kind of look like an almond shape. So I'm curving the line a little bit, curving it the other way. It's gonna have a pointed tip. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we have two ears. If they're not super perfect, don't worry about it, it's okay. What we're gonna do next is fill in the entire llama with white paint. Once you're done that, it's very important to let the base dry and then you're gonna give it a second coat, okay? So very important, because if your base is not dry and you give it the second coat, it won't give you as much coverage, it won't work. So very important to take like a 10-minute break before the first coat, let it dry, and then you'll end up doing a second coat. So here I am just filling it in with the first coat of paint. I'm using my medium brush. You could also switch to your small brush if you'd like to get the smaller details. So as I'm doing this, if you do like our tutorials, please subscribe to our channel. We try to post some every week and we're trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. So please help us out. We really enjoy the support that we've been getting and hope you enjoy our videos as well. So I'm almost finishing off the first coat here. After this, like I said, take a 10-minute break to let it dry. Alright guys, so this is after 10 minutes. My base is pretty dry here. I'm giving it a second coat now. So I just rinsed out my brush, going at it once again with the white paint. Here you could see the color is much brighter now because I have the dry base already. So once again, fill it in. And you could start to kind of adjust your shape here. So if you see some of your lines are a little bit crooked or not clean, you could kind of touch it up. Now's the time. So what I'm doing now is kind of taking my brush and making it come out a little bit more with a small curved line to kind of act like an eyebrow right there for the llama. And again, like I said, I'm gonna finish to fill it in. I'm gonna do the ears, and once that's done, we're gonna continue. So now I'm mixing a light brown paint. There's a few different ways to mix brown. So I take yellow and red, a little tiny bit of black. and then add some white to it to lighten it up. So try to get the same amount of red and yellow, a tiny, tiny bit of black. The black is very, very overpowering, so you don't want to put too much. And you should have a brown color. To lighten it up, you will add some white. So keep a bit of the darker bits and add a bit of white on another section to get a lighter brown. What we're gonna start doing is just adding some details to the llama. So I'm just adding some color to the neckline. I'm gonna be adding a variety of different browns to give it a little more dimension here. I'm going in with some white to blend the harsh line. So wherever you see a harsh line, you could always use some white to blend it in. So I always go back and forth here. Now I'm kind of darkening the brown a little bit by adding a little more black. If you want to create another section on your plate with only dark brown, you could go right ahead. So what I do for the dark brown is red and yellow, black, and just a little bit of white, not too much. Never add too much black, like I said before. So with the darker shade, I'm going to start applying more color to the neck, a little bit of the head. I could start adding some on the ears. I'm keeping my brush strokes pretty messy here. Not worrying about it too much because we are going to be adding more details and blending the color a little bit more. So don't stress too much about it. I'm also coloring in the middle of the face to act like the nose, the snout of the animal, which I'll fill in afterwards. So now I'm getting into my little brush and I'm going to start mapping out where the eyes are going to be. So I'm kind of drawing an eyebrow for the moment and rounding out the eyes. And I'm going to be doing the same thing on the other side. So for now, this is just an idea of where the eye is going to be. We're going to add some lashes and details to them later and a second coat of black paint. So I'm doing the exact same thing on the other side. I'm drawing sort of an eyebrow shape, a diagonal line, and then drawing a rounded eyeball. And now I'm gonna start adding some details on the snout. So I'm gonna do his nostrils. And then we're gonna go back with some brown paint. I'm gonna start adding the mouth, the snout. So I'm gonna kind of curve it in. Two little curved lines, attach them to the nostrils. And I'm gonna create a small mouth underneath as well. And a little chin. So it doesn't, I'm just mapping out the details right now. Like I said before, we will be adding some more dimension to it later. Going in with a little bit more of the lighter brown now and adding more detail. I always tend to like not mix my colors too well on the plate because I kind of like to have all these different tones on the canvas. So I always go between some lighter browns, darker browns, and always make the colors just kind of blend together on the canvas. I'm also adding a few little hairs along the neck. You can alternate between white and light brown for this. Make your lines go in all sorts of different directions. Be very gentle with your brush, not too much pressure and not too much paint. It also helps sometimes to put a little bit of water in the paint to make it a little more runny, more fluid, to create small thin lines like this. So the less pressure you put on your brush, the thinner your line is gonna be. And again, I'm adding some more beige details on the face here, underneath the eyes, and wherever you'd like. So you could do it on the opposite side as well, underneath the eyes. And I'm rounding out his cheeks a little more. So this is where you could kind of touch up your shape, adding some hair on the neckline as well. Working my way all the way down. And once you're done this, you could also add some hairs on the neck itself. So this is gonna give it a little more detail and start to add little strokes of hair everywhere, all the way down. It's gonna also help blend the harsh lines a little more. I'm using white paint for this. Like I said, you could alternate between white and the light browns or dark browns as well. The more variety of colors you have, the nicer it's gonna look. And I'm filling my strokes all the way down. Now I'm gonna start getting into the face a little bit. So I'm gonna add a little more of that beige color, a little bit of white underneath the chin. just to kind of clean up my lines a little bit. Wherever I see my line is a bit crooked or needs some touching up, I'm going to kind of hide it with the white paint or beige. Add some details on the ears as well, so you could create a bit of a highlight on the inside. Add some dark on the outer rim. Here I'm going in with a little bit of a darker brown. I'm mixing, it's quite dark, so I'm gonna do an outline on the ear here just to give it a little more dimension. Add some little baby hairs on the inside. And I'm gonna do the same thing on the other ear to create a little bit of a shadow. I'm going in with a dark brown, tracing the outline of the ear. And adding a bit of details here and there. Going back with some lighter brown on the inside of the ear. And wherever you feel like adding details, you can. The more details you have, the nicer it's gonna look. You could also start adding a few little hairs on the ears themselves or on the head. So here I'm just adding a few white hairs on the head and on the ears with a small brush. Again, never use too much paint for this. When you're taking the paint also with your small brush, you could actually wipe it down on your plate and kind of twist your brush on the plate so you get a nice fine point on your brush. This is gonna help you make those nice fine little lines. Now adding a little more detail on the head. You don't have to do it exactly like me. It doesn't really matter if you're adding dark or lights in different bits. I'm just adding some beige color to the snout and making it go up a little bit more. Here's where I get into the details on the eyes. So I'm just adding, cleaning up my lines a little bit, adding a second coat of black. And it's kind of touch up the cheek just a little bit. And then we're gonna get back to the eyes. Once you do the second coat of black on the eyes and it's nice and dark, you can add a bit of the details, which we'll get to in a second. Just touching up my shapes a little bit, giving a highlight to the eyebrow. So I always alternate between the three colors. I use my lighter brown, my darker brown, and my white paint. You could also add some hairs on the cheeks, both sides. And clean up the snout a little bit. I'm just cleaning up my lines here with some white paint. Again, you can use beige for this or whatever color you'd like, the darker brown as well. So now we're gonna get into the details for the eyes. So I'm cleaning out my brush. Whenever you switch colors, just clean out, make sure you clean out your brush beforehand. That's always important. We could add some lashes now with a small brush. So I'm doing some white lashes because it's on a black canvas, so you can see it a little more. I'm just darkening my nostrils a little bit more with some black paint. And adding a little bit of a darker bit in the mouth. And finally, we're gonna add some highlights to the eye. So two little dots. All right, so that's it for the llama. We're going to make a green color, a dark green for the stem of the rose. So I'm mixing some blue and yellow, a little bit of red to dirty it, and a tiny bit of black. So I'm drawing this diagonal thin line for the stem of the rose that's gonna be in the llama's mouth. I'm doing this on both sides. At the end of the stem, I'm gonna kind of do a little bulb. So it's a small oval shape before we add the rose to that. So for the red, I'm actually going to be mixing with a bit of white paint just to kind of make it a little more opaque because it is on black. So we're gonna have to do a few coats of this. So I'm just doing some petals on the rose, which is just a few little brush strokes here and there. I always mix my red with a little bit of white to make it more opaque. And around the llama, you can start to draw some hearts out with this pink color. We'll give it a coat, let that dry, just same principle as we did for the llama. You're gonna give it one coat, one base coat, let it dry, and then you can apply a second coat to that to make the color more vibrant. It's kind of hard to get good coverage on black, so you'll always have to do a few coats for that. So I'm drawing another heart shape at the top. You could do as many as you'd like and wherever you'd like. So just filling that in a little more, adding some highlights to the rose, adding a bit more red to that just to give it a little more color. So as you see right now, it is fairly transparent. So I'm gonna give it a good 10 minute break, let that dry, and then we are gonna come back to it for a second coat. This is the red paint. So as you see, because it's already dry and I'm applying my second coat, the color is much more vibrant now. So you can start to really see the hearts a little bit better. So we're nearing the end of our painting now. So I'd just like to thank everybody that's been watching. Like I said, if you do like our tutorials, please subscribe to our channel. We will be posting more. We hope you're having fun with them. This is acrylic paint, but you could also use any type of paint you'd like for these. So if you want oils, you could try it with that. It would take a bit of a longer time to dry. That's why I do my tutorials in acrylic paint. I prefer it because it's a lot easier this way and faster. So give it a try. This could be for all ages. You don't have to have any experience to do this. That's it. So I'm just touching up the other heart on the other side. And then I'll touch up the rose just a little bit. So here I am, just again filling them in and touch up the rose just a little bit on the inside to give it a little more color. And there you have it. This is the llama for Valentine's Day.
Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial for beginners. If you like our videos, please subscribe to our channel. We also have an Instagram page at Paint for Fun. And enjoy your day. We'll be posting more soon. Thanks for watching.